So it, we're, but earlier on, before when we were getting ready for the call, we were talking about some of the how some of the important things that are necessary when a team approaches BFGoodrich. And what you said was really key, because we haven't talked about this in any of the webinars before, but it's, you said it's very important for teams, not just to know the company and what your objectives are with products, but to know the trends within the industry. Could you elaborate on that just a little bit? Because I think you really hit a very good talking point that I need to get from that.
Yeah, I think it's important when you reach out to a company to know about them, but about the industry that they participate in. A good example was the tire rankings
we just talked about, and that, you know, how did Michelin perform, BFGoodrich perform against their peer set? You know, educate yourself on where they fit within the competitive set, so you're knowledgeable about the company you are approaching. On the flip side of the coin, you know, prepare yourself when you're presenting a partnership. What is your short-term, your mid-term goal here? You know, a one-year plan, a three-year plan, a five-year plan. So you have steps to build upon. It's just not one and done, and something that's measurable. I will say one of my best learnings in all the years I've been in motorsport and in the marketing roles within motorsport was from an old friend of mine at an OE back in the time, and he says, we want to be partners, not sponsors. Sponsors in the traditional sense, in the old school sense, was very directional. It was, you know, company XYZ provides funding, product to whomever, and 12 months later, you circle back and tell them how many races you won and what you've done, and you had stickers on the car and things. But that method does not work in the 21st century. And the first thing I will tell anybody that I talk to is replace the word sponsorship in your vernacular with partner. Replace it with partnership. It needs to be a win-win for both companies in this day and age. And in companies, in this sense, I'm talking whether it be an athlete or a race team, it needs to be mutual rewarding. Just as a brand awareness exercise, that's not good enough anymore. And I would say the two important things under the partnership are content and commerce. Those are sort of the two big C's to me, content and commerce. And I think both of those have really risen to the forefront in the past 14 months as we've all battled this pandemic, not just domestically, but globally. The partners that were strong with our brands were producing content, pushing content out through their social channels and other means, even when they weren't racing. And that's how they bring value to the brands that they're representing. And if it's just not us, because let's be honest, I mean, a race team, you know, we're there as their tire partner, but they have partners for multiple other hard goods and consumables, and then hopefully other non-endemic companies also. But content is king.
So when a team is trying to create content that is useful and valuable to BFGoodrich or Michelin, what is it you're looking for? Is it content that will be used on social, content for magazine articles, content for publicity, content for posters, content for TV commercials, or do you want actual TV shows? What content should racers be thinking about creating in order to attract your attention to get a sponsorship from a company like yours?
Yeah, it can be any or all of the above. I think what's important is how can you differentiate yourself as an athlete or as a race team from all the other slew of people that are trying to do the same thing. As I mentioned a few minutes ago, I mean, if I receive 1,000 proposals a year, how are you going to stand out from the crowd?